In a mock draft published Monday for Boston Sports Journal, Patriots reporter Mike Giardi predicted the team will take J.J. McCarthy with the number 3 overall pick. Giardi said he knows, quote unquote, for a fact that New England likes McCarthy. So, Keyshawn, here we go again with yet another indication J.J. McCarthy is rocketing up draft boards. Does this change your mind at all about J.J. not even being a first-round pick in your mind?
It doesn't change my mind just because somebody writes that they're going to take him as a quarterback at the number 3 spot or wherever they take him. It doesn't change my mind. I'm not taking J.J. McCarthy with the 3rd pick of the draft. I'm sorry. I mean, I didn't see anything in college football that made me go, oh, my God, that's the number 3 pick in the draft. Because if you're 3, that means you could be 1. Mm. And if you're 3, that means you could be 2. And if you're 1, you could be 3. And if you're 2, you could be 3. So you're telling me right now that our eyes have told us that he's equal to Caleb and Jalen Daniels in our eyes? Because 1 and 3 ain't far apart, Skip. It's just not, okay? Because if those two guys, Jalen Daniels and Caleb Williams, were not on the board, are you telling me that he's the number 1 quarterback if those guys weren't there?
That's
what did you see this year other than winning the national championship to make me go, oh, my God, I got to have this guy?
Well, you just swept that under your little carpet over there about other than winning a national championship. He did do that, and that's what people like about him.
You're on a team.
Yeah.
Okay, you're on a team that's loaded all the way around with a phenomenal coach. I'm just talking about the quarterback position. I'm talking about arm strength. I'm talking about the ability to, because you can't throw the football in the National Football League on a consistent basis 8 times a game. Okay, he threw the ball 8 times against Penn State. They won that one.
In the second half, he threw it no time.
Okay, Ohio State, he threw it 20 times.
Yep.
And in the national championship against Washington, he threw it 18 times.
Didn't need to throw it.
But
I got it.
I still need my quarterback to be able to make all the throws in a game, not in T-shirts, in shorts, at a combine or at a pro day. I need him to be able to do all of those things on a consistent basis. Those reps are meaningful when you transfer it to the National Football League. Mm. They just are. I get it. Yeah, maybe the amazing blue that Tom Brady wore makes you revisit. Well, maybe we can hit again on that one. But to take a quarterback 3 years later, this time, if you took Mac Jones 3 years ago, now you're going to reach for another guy, because I felt like Mac Jones was a reach even though they took him in the middle of the first round, that was a reach then.
Yep.
And however you want to say it, whether Bill screwed it up or he just wasn't good, it didn't work out.
No.
And now you're telling me that I'm getting ready to jump to the 3rd spot to go up and get J.J. McCarthy? Doesn't work for me. Mm. But what the hell do I know? I'm just a guy.
Well, you told me you're good at picking quarterbacks.
I'm just a guy that played the game and caught a lot of balls from a lot of different quarterbacks.
All right. I did not like Mac Jones coming out of Alabama, and I said so here on television ahead of the draft, and I could not believe that Belichick would go up to get him because it was a desperate reach.
Yes.
Oh, maybe I got my next Brady. Nope, you don't. And he had his moments, especially his first year, and then once he fell apart, he stayed falling apart because once you lose your confidence at that position, it's not fair. Mm-hmm. And I do think Mac Jones would have a chance to rebuild himself in Jacksonville as he goes back to his hometown.
See, I don't think he's good, though, but that's just me.
Well, you know what? You're probably right. That's probably the bottom line.
I know everybody want to say that Belichick messed him up by putting Matt Patricia in them. Yeah, that had a little bit to do with it. But even his rookie year, if you really go and you break down the film, it wasn't pushing the ball down the field.
It was not.
Everything was at the line of scrimmage or a few yards behind
the line
of
scrimmage. He's a soft armor. He doesn't have much arm at all.
And so I'm not going to create this narrative as if all of a sudden Mac Jones should have been the first pick of that draft. Right. I'm not going to do that.
Okay. I am here to tell you J.J. McCarthy is better than Mac Jones.
He might be.
Maybe that's not saying a whole lot.
He might be.
But I've told you from the start about J.J., I like him, but I can't go to love him because of what you said. They just didn't throw it enough for me to know because I didn't get to see it on a consistent basis. But here's the point. Does he have enough size to play in the league? You better believe he does.
Yeah, 6'2 and a half, 220 pounds. It's plenty of size.
Is he athletic enough to hurt you with his legs occasionally?
Yeah.
He is.
Does somebody get a hold of him? Yes.
Well, he definitely is. Does he have high football IQ? He does. Does he have a kind of a quirky charisma to him? He does. Did he make a bunch of big throws when they had to be made for Michigan in big games against Penn State and Ohio State and then into the playoffs against Alabama and Washington? He did. He made a lot of big throws when he had to make the throw. Did he consistently riddle teams? Did he pick them to pieces with his arm? He did not, because they didn't do that. They ran the football way more than they threw the football. And that little running back of theirs who's going to be in this draft, he's got some Emmitt Smith in him, ducking and darting behind those linemen. To your point, they annihilated Michael Penix in the championship. They were all over him all night long, and he got battered. Now, I felt for him because he was overmatched against their defense. So what it did was it allowed Jim Harbaugh to call more runs than passes because they did not fall behind and they did not have to throw their way back into games because that's not how they played football. So there's
But even though I'll just stop you in your tracks. Even though they ran the hell out of the football.
They did.
When have you, you've been doing this a long time, Skip. When have you ever seen top three, since that's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
A top three college quarterback projected to go into the draft in the top three. Again, that means you could be one or two. You could be, at that point, you could be anywhere. Not throw the football in college.
No, you're asking a very good question.
Andrew Luck threw the ball.
Yep, he did.
And he was on the same, he was coached by the same guy, running the same plays, using three tight ends.
Yep.
With like, I don't know who was his running back, like Toby Gerhardt or something like that. He was running the football at Stanford. Mm-hmm. But he also was throwing it.
They didn't
take it out of his hands.
A lot.
A lot.
And sometimes he was throwing it to the other team, but that's a whole nother
issue. Again.
Yep.
If you three, you can be one. And he ain't Andrew Luck. So that's my only thing is when I'm looking at this, and I understand this is the hype season of running draft boards up and down
it's
and trying to see.
It's also the smoke screen season.
It's the smoke screen season. Yeah. Yep. Absolutely. Yep. I get it. That's why I'm like, nah, you're not going to get me with this.
So are other teams trying to talk a New England into to overdrafting him at three?
Maybe. Either overdrafting him or trading out of it, the number three spot, making him feel a certain way. I don't know. I would be dumbfounded and shocked to think that they would get him at three when they could possibly get him somewhere else or take one of those other quarterbacks, those Bo Nixes, the Michael Penix, somewhere in the later round.
Good.
And still be able to fill that void at the quarterback position.
Okay. I still say J.J. is better than Bo Nix and J.J. is better than Penix. I believe that.
Okay.
And it's close with Penix because I'm pretty much a fan of his. I just didn't like the way he played in the championship game, but maybe it was just not fair. It wasn't a fair fight. Okay. Because he just unraveled under fire. Okay. So the point is I like J.J. better than I like Drake May. So I have him as the third quarterback. Would I take him third overall? I probably wouldn't because I wouldn't have enough body of work.
That's what we're talking about.
That's all I know.
We're not talking about whether or not he's the third best quarterback.
Yeah.
We're talking about the third overall pick of the draft.
Well, they need a quarterback, obviously.
You know?
Okay.
Yeah, just because, and I tell this to people all the time, just because I need something doesn't mean that I have to reach to go get it. Doesn't mean because I need a wide receiver, I got to draft that guy. I need a defensive tackle, I've got to draft that guy. If you do your due diligence and your homework the way you're supposed to, then you should be able to find that value in that player that fills that void. Because if you miss on him, this is going to set you back 6-7 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is what happens when you take quarterbacks high.
Yeah.
If you miss on quarterbacks, you never rebound.
I saw a quote from Gerard Mayo yesterday to Mike Reese, their beat reporter.
Uh-huh. I love Mike.
So do I. And Gerard Mayo said, I'm not asking for patience, but then again, maybe I am. Because it's like, because they got a long way to go.
It's not too often that you have a Peyton Manning for, whatever, 15 years, and then Andrew Luck falls right as soon as Manning gets hurt, Andrew Luck falls in your lap, because if Manning doesn't hurt his neck, there is no Andrew Luck. It is not very often that you've drafted Deshaun Watson, things happen what they happen with him, and 2 years later, you find C.J. Stroud. Doesn't happen like that.
No.
It usually, you lose a Peyton Manning, and you go for the next 10 years looking for Peyton Manning. You don't find Andrew Luck, or you lose it to Deshaun Watson, and you spend the next 7 and 8 years trying to find them because they're just not out there like
yep.
that. And you wind up reaching
yep.
and grabbing somebody thinking that that's that guy, and it's not that guy. The Cleveland Browns did it for 100 years, and they still try to figure it out.
You lose Troy Aikman, and you spend the next 30 years looking for the next Troy Aikman, right? And we're still trying. We're still searching, and we're looking, and we don't have it. We don't have it.
The facts are, you are correct. You've been searching for Troy Aikman since Troy Aikman left the building.
Correct.
I don't care if it was Hutchinson, Quincy Carter.
How could you even bring him up? But go ahead.
I'm just saying.
I know.
I'm just thinking about the quarterbacks that came after Troy. You've been looking for him ever since.
Who did you play with when you were
there? I played with... Well, Testaverde was older, Drew Bledsoe, Drew Henson. Those were the three that took snaps. Tony Romo was on our practice squad. Mm. But those three guys were the ones who actually took snaps. And Quincy Carter was there, but he wound up getting released in training camp.
Okay. Did you see